The Kamala Harris campaign performs election interference by trying to bribe Cornell West. We have the video on that. And Victoria Shanahan gives the reason why Trump is so great and why the Democrat Party, they don't listen and they're anti-science. Welcome to John Mike Keene. Here's Cornell West.
Just one more on this. Did they offer you? Did they offer you a cabinet position, a lower position, and offer to pay off any of your campaign debt?
Well, they offered serious substantive conversation about all of those that could lead toward some real
gotcha.
Possible.
That's a huge yes, because that's how Democrats do it, is they want to arm's distance from their payments. So they offer a cabinet position or some other thing that will be an in-kind payoff of your debt. Cornell West used to be a Democrat of some kind, far on the left, radical guy running for president. And this is yet another candidate that the Democrats expose themselves and show that when they say that democracy is on the ballot, they don't realize that they're talking about themselves. They've made similar deals and oppressed and investigated other candidates, including Greenie Jill Stein. So your environmental policy does not make you safe. RFK, and now they're dorking around with all of his, which ballot he's going to be on, which one he's not. These are not serious people. Here's Victoria Shanahan. This is Bobby Kennedy, RFK's running mate on the Democrat Party.
Why are you, who's known for being a savvy person, so quick to trust that Donald Trump will deliver on what he says?
How can you, a savvy person, support Donald Trump is really unpacks this loaded question.
Look, where we are right now is we have taken a year. Bobby's been running for over a year. We have crossed this nation. We have talked to Americans. We have met people from all ends of the political spectrum, which is what you should be doing if you are running for a representative office.
100%.
You should be out there listening. And our job is to bring that voice to whomever is going to be sincere in their reception to hearing the American public, where they're hurting, what is going on.
Cuomo agrees that they should be listening and agrees that they are listening to the people and that they will take their policies to anyone. But who listens? Is it the open-minded, zen, new age Democrats, the soft people, the sensitive people, the active listening people? Did they listen?
Farmers are so underrepresented right now. And this is why I brought up some of my criticisms of Kamala Harris's food cap economic policy, right? Mm-hmm. Or food price capping. Farmers are on their knees in this country right now. They are not price gouging.
Farmers are begging for help. And Kamala Harris gives an anvil to a drowning man. That's their candidacy. They're making it worse on farmers, even accusing them of the crime of price gouging.
To say that our farmers are price gouging when they are already on their knees, who can I take that message to today? You tell me,
that's a fair
Chris,
criticism.
Who's going to listen
that's
to me?
Because
I have taken this message for years to the Democratic Party, and I cannot get through to anybody. It's not like this has happened overnight.
Chris Cuomo admits it's a fair point. He's conceding that the Democrats are not listening to this issue with the farmers.
I didn't wake up one morning and say, what a great idea it would be to leave the Democratic Party. No, I tried everything in my capability to get through to someone who would listen and hear this actual science, to hear the people on the ground, to listen to American voices.
Oh, did you hear that? She said to have someone listen to the science.
Hear this actual science.
Democrats do not listen to the science. They mouth those words, but they're anti-science. They despise science. They're a religion. They're a liberal, progressive cult. They have no interest in facts and science, which Shanahan brought to them. Who will listen to the science? Oh, the answer might surprise you, but if you're a Trump fan, it won't.
We've got to judge people by their reactions. We got to judge people by the people around them. And right now, Trump has some really good people around him, and he's willing. He's more than willing to listen.
Trump listens to the science. She's saying, like, you have to judge people by their actions, implying that Chris Cuomo judges him by trying to say he's evil or fashion or whatever's popular with the Democrat Party. And she's going, you have to judge him by the people he surrounds him with. It also implies that Kamala surrounds herself by bad people that also won't Listen to the science. This is a great interview, a huge indictment destroying the Democrats and exposing them for what we all know about them.
He wants to listen, understand, verify, and then say, all right, who's going to help me get this done? And Bobby has been right up there next to him being like, I will get this done with you.
So Trump wants to listen, verify, and get it done. And Democrats, just by counterexample, do not want to listen, identify the problem in truth, and then do something about it. This is a huge compliment to Trump and a huge indictment of Democrats, including Cornell West, calling them out just for bribing him. And they are his number one enemy. The people fighting for Cornell West's right to be on the ballot are all Republican right now. I'm John Mike Keane.